Good morning. We are in Monticello, Idaho. Iowa. And we've got to go over to this plastics plant here and pick up a load going to Bedford, Pennsylvania. And try to get it loaded. So we're on our way. I'm awake. I was exhausted yesterday. I mean, wiped out. I did not do an outro, which, you know that now. So I got over here to Monticello and passed the fuck out. I mean, I went to bed at like 7 o'clock last night because I was just exhausted. And so we're up, we're moving, we're heading over here to get loaded. I'm still tired. And then after that, we're gonna. I did get my water cup. Okay. See my nice water cup. Friend got me that for Christmas, along with the hat. And then my adopted family got me two sets of shoes, whose name escapes me right now. Every good Peterbilt driver wears these shoes. Anyway, so I got two pairs of those, and then everything. But I absolutely love this cup. I don't know why, outside from the fact it says Peterbilt on. I use it over everything else. I've got like 4 cups on the truck, and this cup is the cup that I use all the time. Just because, I guess, it's just right. It fits in the cup holder. I can, you know, just pick it up, drink it. It's a perfect cup. So it was a good deal. My friend did a good job finding that cup. Very happy with it. Anyway, all right, let's go over here. Let's get loaded. Let's try to get to Pennsylvania. It's a long trip, but we have to be there tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock in the morning, and it's 8 o'clock in the morning now in Iowa. And I'm not entirely sure it's doable, but I'm not entirely sure it's not doable either. So, anyway, I'll see you in a little while. We're back in the, actually this worked pretty well yesterday with just the punch. I think what I'll do is punch it instead of, we're gonna roll out of here. I talked to, the broker about what time I need to be in, Pennsylvania. Turns out it is a first come, first serve deal. So, because of that, I can go straight in. I can just drive today, which is kind of nice. So that's what we're working on. So we're going to head out, to the 38. Which way are we going? So we're heading out of Monticello. We're gonna go back up the 151 to the 38. See if I can find myself. And then we're going to go down the 38 south to the 64. Take the 64 across to the... So that's Iowa 38, Iowa 64 across to my... I don't know how to pronounce that town. M-A-Q-U-O-K-E-T-A. I'd want to pronounce it Maquita, Iowa, which I... Or Maquita or Maquita. I think it's Maquita, so we'll go with that. US 61 south to DeWitt. And then probably from DeWitt, we're going to go east on US 30 and cross the Mississippi at Clinton, Iowa. And then we'll be in Illinois. And then from there, we'll take 30 over to, I think, we'll follow 30. I know that much. Hold on. Let me look it up. Here we are. Okay. So we'll follow 30 over to, I think, like, the 40, right at, like, Sterling, Sterling, Illinois, and we'll take the 40 down to the 80, and then from there, we'll take the 80 over to the 39, we'll go down the 39 into Normal and Bloomington, we'll take the 74 across to Indiana, and then... Let's see. 74 goes into Indianapolis, and then we'll take the 70 out of Indianapolis and go all the way to Ohio, and then from Ohio, and we're going to stop in New Paris, Ohio. One way or the other, we're stopping in New Paris, Ohio at the Petro there. So, that's the plan. I need to pull up the, Iowa on the map and keep it out, because that's the one that I have to concentrate on, so. Now. My. Both of my GPSs are not going to route me this way. So the GPS, for a faster route, the GPS, the Google GPS is routing me 38 to the 64 to the 61. And then down to the 80, and then around through Davenport, follow the 74 down to Peoria, and then through Bloomington, Normal, and then on out to Indiana. And the thing is, it's like, it'll be a little bit faster to go to Clinton and then go to Sterling. It'll probably be a little bit slower, but that's what we're going to do. And the reason is because that's the way I want to go. So, and for obvious reasons as to why that's the way I want to go. So that's what we're going to say. We're going to the Petro in New Paris, Ohio. Okay. From my location. So 7 hours and 6 minutes. Okay. All right, let's go. Come on. Going along with me, but what I'm gonna do, I'll get out on the highway. When I get out on the highway, I'm gonna put some music on for a minute or two, just boost my confidence a little bit. You know, I need to do that every morning. So anyway, all right, let's get out of here. You stay there, I'll stay right here, and I will see you in a little while. Pine City, Bedford, Pennsylvania. Four. One. Navigate. Well, a few minutes out of the gate today, and ran across. I'm on Iowa 38 right now, and I ran across this tractor and a planter going down the highway. And so, real quick, hold on. You can finish that shaving a haircut at home. So I'm not gonna finish it. I know it's gonna aggravate people, don't care. So here's the deal. It's planting season. Okay? It's seeding season, it's planting season, it's whatever. There are signs in small states like this along the highway that outline to you that if you're on the back roads, it's planting season, and be aware of the fact that farm equipment's gonna be traveling up and down the roads, okay? I'm a big believer in going and using the back roads, okay? This is not a great example of back roads being smoother, but I have found that back roads are much more pleasant to travel. So they're pleasant to travel because of the roads are typically smoother, they're pleasant to travel because the people are friendlier, they're pleasant to travel because of the scenery, they're pleasant to travel, okay? You can use back roads to get where you need to go, and it's not gonna add that much time. Take the back roads, okay? It's a slower way of life, I totally understand that. It's not for everybody. Plenty of people just wanna get there, and I get that too. I'm not making any less money because I take the back roads, okay? But understand that when you come up behind somebody on the back road like that, when you come up behind a tractor or a farm truck or something, you know, give them space. I mean, these guys are feeding the country, you know, trying to, and half of them, you know, half of what they sell or three quarters of what they sell, maybe it doesn't go to us in America, maybe it goes to other parts of the world, but they're not, you know, so they're not just trying to feed the country, they're trying to feed the world, in all honesty. We import a lot of stuff out of this country to other countries as far as food, beans and rice and everything, so be aware of that. Give your farmers space. Give your guys that are, hauling cows or sheep or whatever space. Give them space. You know, because they're doing the Lord's work, in all honesty. You know, and everything. But, you know, be courteous, be kind, and make sure you give plenty of space to the people that are on the back road, because they're going to give it to you. You know, you saw that, you know, that farmer just now. You know, he moved over and drug his planter along the shoulder, and they gave me the space to go around him. And before then, he was not necessarily providing that space, and it was kind of nice. So, you know, that's it. That's my tip for driving along the back roads. So, anyway, onward and upward.
This
the broker's calling. Just a second. Hello? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I did. No, I'm in Clinton, Iowa. Yeah, Iowa. Yeah, well, I'm just crossing into Illinois. I just crossed the Mississippi River. The gentleman I talked to earlier said that it was the first come, first serve. Okay. So, I don't know if it's going to be 9 a.m. in the morning. I think that's a little ambitious, considering I left about 10 o'clock, and I'm going to lose an hour going to spam. I want you guys to see my handiwork pulling this out. So we're in Crawfordsville, Indiana, and I stopped because the trucks are yelling at me about low coolant. And I get out, start looking for a leak, and I find one right there. So this hose, this hose right here had split down here, and that's a clamp. I took another little piece of hose, like I slid it in half, and then I put two clamps around it and clamped it down. And I'm hoping it holds, but it looks like it's actually holding. I don't see any coolant. I see coolant on the ground, but not on the exhaust. And I don't see any fresh coolant leaking in now. So I think. I think it's fixed. So the plan is to go in here to this Pilot and get a shower, and then go on to New Paris, Ohio, and stop there and get a piece of hose. And they probably shut down for the night and let the engine cool, get up in the morning and try to replace this. I don't know. Or try to let them replace it. I have no clue. So we're gonna see what we do. But I'll keep y'all updated.